What is a doorstep scam? Doorstep scam takes place with someone comes to your door, a stranger, and tries to scam you out of your money or tries to gain access to your home. Aren't always pushy and persuasive. They may seem polite or friendly, so if you're not expecting someone, it's important to be vigilant when you answer the door, especially if you live on your own. It can be very easy to fall victim to a scam, but you can be scam savvy if you know what to look out for. What are some common types of doorstep scams? There are many different types of doorstep scams. Some of the most common ones include rogue traders, a cold caller. You may often offer your services you don't really need. They may claim to have noticed something about your property that needs work or improvement, such as the roof, and offer to fix it for cash. Bogus officials. People claim to be from your utility company as a way of gaining access to your home. Always check the ID of any officials, and if they are genuine, they won't mind waiting while you check. Fake charity collections. A fundraiser may pretend they're from a charity and ask you to donate money, clothes, or household goods. Legitimate charities will always have a charity number that can be checked on the charity confirmation website. Made up customer survey. Some scams ask you to complete a survey so they can get hold of your personal details or use it as a cover for pressure you to buy something you don't want or need. Hard luck stories. Someone may come to your door and ask you to help them out for cash, ask to use your telephone, or claim they're feeling unwell. The story is made up to con you out of your money or gain access to your home. If someone does come to your door, it's important to remember the following. Only let someone in if expecting them or their trustworthy friend, family member, or a professional. Don't feel embarrassed about turning someone away. Don't feel pressured. Don't agree to sign a contract or hand over money at the door, and talk to someone you trust. You should always check someone's ID. You can phone the company, but never use contact details they give you. Never share your PIN number or let anyone pressure you to hand over your bank card or withdraw cash. Call the police non-emergency number 101 if you're not in immediate danger but want to report an incident. Call 999 if you feel threatened or in danger.